What's up, guys? My name is DJ Swivel, and on this week's episode of In The Mix, we're actually debuting a brand new song from an incredible artist, Young Baby Tate, produced by Take A Day Trip. It's called Eeny Meeny. But before we get started, make sure you like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, leave a comment, do what you gotta do. Run the intro.
DJ Swivel.
In The Mix.
What's up, guys? I am DJ Swivel, and we're back for another episode of In The Mix. On today's episode, it's actually pretty special because we get to actually debut a song, first time you're ever going to hear it. The artist is Young Baby Tate. The song is Eeny Meeny, produced by Take A Day Trip. I love this song. It feels like a hit to me. So I'm going to share it with you guys today. As with every In The Mix, first thing we do is we go over the system usage. We're only using 49 voices, so it's actually a pretty small session. It's only about maybe about 10 or 12 tracks in the beat here. And then we have a number of vocal tracks. So we will go through it all. But before we get started, make sure you like, subscribe, comment, hit the notification bell, do what you got to do. And let's dig right into it. So this is a hip hop record. There's a super catchy hook. As you can see, there's a lot of edits in the beat here. This is very typical of hip hop records. The reason you notice this across the whole beat is because usually in hip hop, the producer will send just a two track instrumental, like just one instrumental file like this up here. And often their engineers or the artists themselves will do edits to the instrumental to just, like, you know, give it a little vibe. Maybe you do a repeat of a kick drum, or you do some drops. And so basically all of these edits that we have going all the way through the beat here, this is just like a count in of the 808. Here's, you know, a little drop. Here's another like stutter edit, more sort of stutter edits here. That's basically just copying what the engineer and Young Baby Tate did when they were in the studio. So that's why all of these look identical. And again, that's very typical of hip hop records. I've been doing, making these sorts of edits for my whole career, pretty much. Okay, so let's dig in. Well, we have, let's just sort of break down all the elements of the track. We have a kick drum here. Simple stuff. What do we have on it? We have a Brainworks BX Boom. I love this on kick drums. It does some really cool stuff. There's three modes, low, mid, and high. I've got it set to high and not going too crazy. It goes up to 100. We're at 34 here. Then we have this Alicia envelope. This is adding some, it's a transient shaper. We're killing the sustain. We're adding a little bit of attack on the top at about 28 hertz, so pretty much everything. And then we have another compressor on top of that. And then we have this VMR adding a little bit of this like low harmonic saturation twice, actually. So slightly different frequencies, just getting as much low end out of this kick as we can. And let's hear the kick with nothing on it. So not louder, but more subby. I would say. And there's a little bit, you can kind of hear, there's a little bit of saturation on that kick as well, which helps, you know, cut through. Keep in mind, we have an 808 that's running all the way through it. So that kick is really just hitting at certain select moments in the song. As you can tell, you know, there's no kick really up until this second chorus. All right, what else do we have? We have a clap, not much going on that. What do we have on it? Just an H comp, nothing too crazy. Let's hear it. Cool. And I'm sure if I take it off, you're just going to hear maybe not as much attack on it, but why don't we just loop it? You hear a little bit more attack on it. Nothing too crazy. Very subtle stuff happening there. We have this other clap. Nothing's on it. Simple. We got a hi-hat. Let's hear what that's doing. Uh, Again, just getting a little more attack out of those hi-hats, a little more transient, nothing too crazy. Let's see, we have an open hat here, nothing on it. Real simple. And another open hat here that happens once every measure. More natural sounding open hat. And we have this scratch sound, which I think only happens once or twice in the song. We have it early here, right? That I've raised the volume on it a lot in this one section. I'll play it all together. I just want to get through the drums and then I'll play all the drums together. And then we have it again down here, just like a little break section. So that would actually be a good time to listen to it in context with the drums. And once we add the 808, which there's actually some special stuff happening on that, it'll sound like this. So that little scratch there is just kind of to break up this drop. Okay, so that's the drums, nothing too crazy. And to be honest, when you're mixing hip hop records, oftentimes you don't really have to go crazy with the drums. Usually, you know, these are resampled drums. They've been mixed and, you know, processed 100 times. You don't often have to do much because the kick drum was not the main low-end driving instrument. The 808 is. You know, I wanted to process this kick a little bit differently just to, like, kind of lock in with the 808 here. So speaking of the 808, let's talk about that. And there's some very special things going on it. All right, so let's listen to it with nothing. And now we're going to add. Now we'll take away. Now we'll add it again. So a lot more low end happening on that 808, and there's some, you know, little resonant stuff going on. So what are we doing? We have an R bass, 51 Hertz, pretty low on the setting. It's just adding some of that subby, very low subby stuff. And then we have something with which this might be the debut. And as you're about to see, it is completely unfinished. This is actually the next plugin that I'm developing. It's called Noctonal. And as you can see, we're not even out of version one. So it's undesigned. There's no UI. We haven't done a nice attractive GUI. We're just messing with the sounds. I'm not going to get in too deep with it, but it allows you to, you know, push and mess with the resonances of certain notes in your drums. So for example, we have it an E here, and so we're pushing an E. So I'm not going to dig too deep into Noctonal, but I will A-B it so you can kind of hear what it's doing. So I'll leave the R bass on, and let's get rid of Noctonal, and then I'll add it about halfway through. So it's actually doing quite a bit. Let me play it one more time. Let me get a better loop here. And the first loop will have no Noctonal, and then we'll add it for the second loop. So it allows us to push certain resonating frequencies in really nice ways. Amazing on kick drums, 808s, snares, rim shots, really any drums. But if you want some tonality to your drum, this will eventually be the plugin for you. Okay, so moving on. Damn, we're debuting a song, hasn't been released, nobody's heard it, it's coming out soon. And we're debuting a plugin, hasn't been released, coming out soon. Look at that. Okay, so this synth bass, let's hear it. So we're adding a little bit of low frequency. To be honest, it's not doing much. Very subtle. You might hear it on big speakers. I'm in the headphones. I'm not hearing too much of it. All right, so simple synth bass. We have another synth bass here. I think it's got more low end in it. Yeah. So we've got a compressor giving it a little edge, and then we have some transient shaping as well. but nothing too crazy. Simple stuff. Okay, let's go to the intro synth. And what do we have? So, really simple. We have a basic compressor, just making sure that, you know, this is kind of like a drum, you know, it's a percussive synth, let's call it. And we want to just sort of even out the volume of each of the notes because each note seems to have its own volume. And then there was one like little weird frequency there, 2300 hertz, that was a little bit irritating on one note. So I've just kind of cut that out. Let's listen. So as you can see, this one right here, we just like kind of yanked that one down. So another real simple tweak. And then what do we have? I think this is the same sound that goes all the way through. And I believe we have probably the same settings. Yep, there you go. Although I think we've increased how much we're taking out that one note. Because let's see. Yep, we're increasing it by about 3 dB. So negative 6 on that. Let's hear it. So you can tell it just smooths out the sound a little bit. If you turn it up, you'll start to get some of those resonating frequencies starting to pierce your ears. So we just kind of duck that a little bit here. Again, 2338 hertz. Okay, what else do we have? We have this other synth that only happens a few times and there's no processing on it. There's a delay on it that was processed from the producer's day trip. Of course, you know, I've adjusted levels on a lot of these things as one does, but nothing too crazy. Just to, you know, I wanted this synth bass to really stand out, so that's up a bit. Let's see what else. This main synth, I wanted that to stand out. It's a simple beat, so you want to find those sounds that you can really, like, bring to life and make the center kind of center focus of the track. And then the last thing, no processing on it, is just the day trip tag. We've all heard it before, and now we're hearing it again. Okay, so there's a lot going on the vocals. Let's dig into that. Now, I received this as a, rather than stems, as a Pro Tool session from Young Baby Tate's engineer. And he did some interesting things on it, which some of which I've kept. And so, you know, he has an all-vox bus. This is mostly his settings. I think I may have made a few little adjustments probably on this EQ here. Yeah, some little adjustments to the EQ. There were some resonating frequencies. We're just ducking some of that, some corrective things. Nothing too crazy. But all of the vocals run through that all-vox bus. And I believe, is there some automation? No, we don't even have automation. We're not even using the sends. These were there and we didn't use them at all. Okay, so let's just go into the regular vocal tracks and see what we're doing. So here's the first, this is the chorus lead. Let's hear what it's doing.
Just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like any, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe?
Okay, so classic radio effect. There's some reverb, there's some delay. We have these delay throws that are going on, but let's just start. What is giving it the radio effect? Well, there's some corrective EQing going on there. We have this one knob driver that's giving it a little distortion. And then we have this one knob filter pulling it down to, this doesn't really say what frequency it's at, but you just kind of use your ears. And then we have some soothe on there to just correct some of the resonance. And yeah, and then we're doing some additional like kind of de-essing here around 3K-ish. So let's hear what that sounds like with nothing. And then it's running through this hook vox bus as well. And again, a lot of these things are ported over from, her engineer, and then we make some adjustments to make it work. So let's hear with nothing on it.
Just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose.
So kind of we're getting the radio effect from the main track plugins, and then on the bus we're doing more of the compression and just, you know, bringing the vocal to life a bit. Let's just have a quick look at what's going on with these delay throws. So you can kind of hear them. It's this long delay. So you'll see as we cross the automation, you'll see it opens up. And what is on it? Where is the long delay?
Just broke up with my dude.
Oh, right here. Swiv delay. So what do we have? We have a quarter note H delay. We are just kind of lo-fying it, I guess, putting a radio effect on it. And then we have a little bit of a flanger, a little bit of compression. So we're kind of bringing the tail doesn't sort of echo out quite as much. Or it doesn't sort of trail off quite as much. And then we're spreading it super wide using my plugin Spread. As you can see, there is a new update coming to Spread, which I've been testing. So we're actually adding MS functionality now, and now you have an output trim. So we are tightening that up, and you guys will get that soon. Free update for every Spread user who has the plugin already. And then in addition to that, we are sending that delay to this R-verb delay, which is here. It's going to an R-verb. It's a simple plate. There's again some sort of radio filtering, lo-fi filtering, and a little bit of compression and some an S1 imager there to just widen it a bit as well. This was the client Young Baby Tate engineer's reverb. I liked what he did on it, so I just kind of left it as is. Okay, so that's what we have in the hook vocal, and then we have these ad libs. Let's just take a look at them. What are they doing? So as you can tell, it's panning kind of left and right. There's some modulation on it. It sounds like a flanger. So let's dig into it. What do we have? Well, we have some corrective EQing going on. And then we have this auto panner that is just kind of like sending things left and right. You'll see. As you can see where my mouse is there, it's just kind of panning left and right. And then that runs through this bus. Again, a little brightness, just some corrective EQing, basic compression. There's an RVox, a second layer of compression there, and then it's radioed out again. And then even more compression. I'll be honest, a lot of this is typically I don't use quite as many plugins, but every engineer has their own way. And, you know, when you're mixing off of a Pro Tools session that the engineer and artists and producers have already worked on quite a bit, it doesn't really make sense to just get rid of everything and start from scratch. So I'm kind of building and tweaking what was already there, because we all like the vibe of the vocal, and no sense in changing it. The vibe was right. We just do some corrective EQing and little things just to touch it up and get it feeling a little, just a little more polished. So there's, of course, the Valhalla Vintage Verb on all of the ad libs. Then that's being spread wide with the S1 imager. We have some slight, the mix is at 60%. So some slight resonance shaping, you can call it, resonance fixing. And then we have another corrective EQ, because there was some additional resonance here that I just wanted to pull more out of. So 1700 and 2000 hertz, roughly. And that is going to this quarter echo as well, which I believe is just a quarter note, but it's got some modulation on it. That's where you're hearing there's a metaflanger on it. So quarter note, ping pong, it's going left and right. Again, radioed out. We have some flanger on it, and then a little bit of compressor and the stereo widening. So let's hear it one more time. So you can hear on that delay as it kind of hits back, you're hearing the flanger on it. Okay, so that is the ad libs, and of course all the ad libs throughout the track are pretty much processed. Well, they are processed identically. And, you know, the hooks are mostly processed identically, although this one is radioed and these ones don't sound like radio. They sound more like full voice. So let's hear that.
Just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two.
So other than the fact that it doesn't have the filtering and the drive, the distortion, it's pretty much the same vocal. It's just slightly different processing on it. But of course it has the same delay throws. We've raised the volume of the second and third hook because they sound a little bit different. And of course in this first hook, you'll notice there's not much going on in the beat, no drums happening really. So once more of the drums come in, you know, we want to raise the hook because there's more things happening. We want that hook to be just as impactful. So let's see how much we raise it. About 2.5 dB. So all these drums and things kind of account for about 2.5 dB of additional volume in your track. And so, yeah, you want to compensate for that. So that's what we did. Okay, let's look at the verses real quick. So what's on the verse? Some corrective EQ. And it's running through this one bus. There's a de-esser. There is a compressor, an R-comp. I believe another comp, compressor, R-vox. And then, again, some selective sort of EQ, just pulling out some of the weird frequencies. And then we have this S1 imager, which is not really being used. I just kind of left it on because it was, you know, sometimes you just don't want to mess with the setup of the original engineer's session. And then we have, again, some soothe here, just like correcting some of those like resonating frequencies. There's like a fair bit of resonance happening in this song, which when I start to play the song, you won't really hear it. But if I got rid of a bunch of things, you'd start to hear some of these like piercing frequencies. So that's what soothe is kind of handling, some of that stuff. Okay, so why don't we listen to the verse, you know, just the whole thing, because we haven't really heard the whole track. I'll play kind of coming out of the hook here into the verse, just so you guys get an idea of how the track is coming together. And then there's these really amazing background vocals that we'll dig into as well.
Like eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Yeah, eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Yeah, eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Before I suck that ding-a-ling, better let me know. Is you STD freak? Let the record show. Tell it all, nigga, get up in these walls, nigga. I shade this pussy ball before I fuck a ball, nigga. 5'2", fine too, still fuck a tall, nigga. You know I don't discriminate, cause I need all figures, yeah. Get that money, dollar, dollar bill, oh, yeah. Gotta hold it to the light, make sure it's real, oh, yeah. I'm just saying, 9 times out of 10, oh, yeah. If I fuck her once, I probably fuck again, oh, yeah. Just broke up.
So that gives you an idea of the song. As you can tell, coming into the hooks, we have these like repeated, 808 and kick drums. That was, again, like just copying the original demo. And as you can tell, about 2/3 of the way through that verse, we start getting some of these like really gorgeous backgrounds. So why don't we dig into those a little bit? These backgrounds here are kind of just doubles. Let's start with the doubles first, because I think they're easier to go over. Let's hear them.
Shoot STD free, let the record show. Ow, nigga. Wilds, nigga. Pull up a bow, nigga.
So this is simple. It's really not processed too crazy. There's some corrective EQing on everything. And then, you know, a little more, some of those resonating frequencies are getting pulled out. And then just some compression and some reverb. And again, there's a little soothe on there too. Also some additional EQing that was done. So that's pretty straightforward. I mean, hard pan, well, not quite hard pan, but about, it's a 55% pan left, right. So you get some nice stereo image on those doubles. And it just like allows a lift in the verse. So why don't I play the verse with those, just so you can hear kind of what sort of energy they add to it.
Tell it all, nigga, get up in these walls, nigga. I shade this pussy ball before I fuck a ball, nigga. 5'2", fine too, still fuck a tall, nigga. You know I...
So they're not too loud. They're just there to support that lead vocal just a little bit. And I think, her timing is perfect. Really nice touch. This is standard practice for most hip hop records. Let's go into these background vocals because I love them. They add like this R&B vibe, almost like a Twigs vibe kind of. Let's hear them.
Yeah.
So what's going on? Well, we have four of them. They're stacked perfectly, I might add. Two are panned 100% left, two are panned 100% right, so we get a nice wide image. We don't want it fighting with that lead vocal in the middle because we still have a wrap going on. So these are just meant to kind of wrap around that vocal, no pun intended. And, you know, I did make some adjustments with, you know, I didn't want them to come in too early. So I did mute these and it seemed like everyone liked that. I muted them earlier in that first verse. And then in the second verse, they're kind of all the way through the verse. So I kind of, sometimes in hip hop records, they can feel a little linear, right? If you just have a verse and a hook and the beat doesn't change a whole lot, it can be difficult to find ways to make the song feel like it grows and add change ups and things like that. So this is just a simple way to make, you know, the second verse feel bigger than the first verse. You have these backgrounds that come in from the beginning. Let's hear them.
Which one? Pick one. Turn them to a sick one. That one, this one. Opposite a big pun. Yes, big fun. Said he got a big gun.
So these are less rappy, more singy, but having them in makes that second verse feel a little bit bigger and just allows the song to grow. You know, you don't want to get bored when you're listening. Okay, so what are we doing on these more R&B backgrounds? Again, some corrective EQing, nothing crazy really. I mean, it's just about adding some reverb and a little bit of compression, a little bit of EQ. There's really nothing crazy going on here. So I've got them, in addition to being spread 100, 100, I've spread on there, pushing them nice and wide. And then we have Soothe on there as well, just softening them up. She had some interesting frequencies in her voice that, you know, that just helped get rid of. And then it's just going to a simple D-verb. That's it. I believe it is this one. You know, there's a D-verb on it. It's the large hall setting, and again, you know, they've kind of limited the frequency spectrum of it a bit. There's a little bit of compression, and then it's spread out wide using this S1 imager, so it kind of just gets out of the way of the vocal. Okay, and then same thing on these. There's those same backgrounds, I mean, same style backgrounds in the hook. Let's hear them.
What am I do? Now I need to, yeah. Trying to do, so I'm trying to choose, yeah.
Let's hear it with the rap.
Just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like, eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Yeah, eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Which one, pick one?
So love that. I mean, very R&B vibe, but like cool, not too like, not old school or anything. Like I said, it feels like Twigs-ish to me. And that's kind of it. And then we have this other layer. Let's hear this. So it's like a singing, it's like matching her rap, but it's singing. So I'll play it with the rap.
Come and lick up on this pussy cat, 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 cat. Love the way you eat it from the back, 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 back. But we ain't getting married, I'm a Mac, 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 yeah.
So yeah, really great. I love those backgrounds. They kind of made the record. I mean, the hook is catchy and the beat's catchy and simple, but having those backgrounds just gave it this added dynamic layer, which I thought was great. And to be honest, that's kind of it. I mean, that's really, there's not too much complexity in the record. You know, there is a lot of vocal processing, but, you know, nothing that we're not reinventing the wheel here, you know? And so let's just take a look at I also actually mastered this record, which I don't often do, but sometimes when clients ask, I do it. So let's just see my mastering process, you know, in the few occasions when I do choose to master. So I love using this. This is the Slate FGX. I always like adjust the settings a little bit, but I start with Steven's mastering hard, adding some low punch and some detail. This adds like just a little bit of attack on the low frequencies. This adds a little bit of attack on the high frequencies. So, you know, when you push the detail, some of those hi-hats pop out a little more. When you push the low punch, those kicks pop out more. And we have some basic like 2-to-1 compression, you know, slow attack, fast release. The threshold isn't low. So let's see how much that's compressing the track.
Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like eeny, meeny, money, mo. Which one are you looking?
So as you can tell, it's only getting between 1 and 2 dB of compression, and it's really helping that kick pop through. So that's the first step. Second step is ozone. So love ozone, use it all the time. Let's hear what that's doing. I'll play, and then about, I don't know, a bar or two in, I'll bypass ozone, and you'll start to hear it.
Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like eeny, meeny, money, mo.
So pretty subtle, but there's actually a lot going on. So let me show you. We start with some multiband dynamics, and we're doing like processing on both the mid and the side differently. So we're not processing it stereo. We're processing everything mid-side. So let's see. In the upper frequencies, we're in the middle, we're pulling out just like a little under a dB of the middle, but we're pushing that amount in the side. So that gives us a little more image in the upper frequencies. And again, the compressors are just kissing, you know, we're not doing too much compression. So you'll see.
Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do?
So as you can tell, and that's generally the same for most of these parameters. So I don't have to show every single one. The compression is very little. We're talking like 1 to 2 dB of compression. Okay, so the upper mids, we're not adding anything in the mid, but we are adding about a dB and a bit on the side. And in the low mids, we're not boosting any gain, but we have, you know, different compression settings. And then in the low, we're boosting the mid, and we're probably, yeah, not doing anything to the side because there probably isn't much happening in the sides on the low there. Okay, so we start with these multiband dynamics, a 4-band multiband compressor. Then we go into a 4-band imager. And I do this all the time. Very common thing. I will narrow the low frequency. So everything below 140, I'll narrow. And then usually around, you know, in the low mids, I don't really do much. I'm increasing the width just a little bit, not too much. And then in the upper mids, we're increasing the stereo a bit more. And then in the highs, we're increasing it a bit more. And what I find this does, it's actually very subtle, and I can A-B it for you, but it just creates a slight amount of separation between frequencies, and it just makes your whole track feel a little bit wider. So let's hear it.
Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like eeny, meeny, money, mo.
So I turned it on and off a few times there. You can go back and listen. Let me know if you hear it. It's subtle, but it's definitely helpful. It helps bring the mix to life a little bit. We have some basic tape saturation. It's not doing too much. We're pushing the input drive like a little under 5 dB. Let's A-B it and hear what it's doing.
Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like.
So it just feels like you get a little more aggression in the low end to me. But it's subtle. It's not doing anything too crazy. And then this spectral shaper, I started using this a lot. And what it's doing is it's basically taming the super subby frequencies below 40 hertz. And the reason I started doing this was actually because of a Chainsmoker mix I did for Paris. So I did this mix for Paris, and we mastered it, and it was ready to go, but we hadn't released it yet. And they were going to debut it at a, where were we? LA Convention Center. They had a big It wasn't New Year's Eve. It was December 30th, and this would have been probably 4 years ago now. So I was in front of house, which is the best place to listen to the mix. And I thought the mix was great. And then they played the song and I was sitting next to their manager and I said, and I heard the song and just the low end was way too heavy. It just didn't translate quite the way that I wanted it to. And so I told him, I was like, I got to go back and make an adjustment to the mix. I heard it live in this setting. And you know, it's rare where you get to hear things in a live setting like that. And we were in front of house and I could tell the rest of the song sounded perfect. But this song, just the low end was pushing. It was just too heavy. It really was knocking like a hip hop record. And it really wasn't. It was like a pop EDM record. So I started using the spectral shaper and it just tames those low subby frequencies so that it's not like overwhelming you in a nightclub or a setting like that. So you're still getting low end, you're still getting punch, you're still getting those kicks and 808s are hitting, but it's just not going to overpower. And like we've all been in the club when you have to kind of plug your ears because the low end is so much. This kind of prevents that a little bit. And so basically all it's doing is it's compressing everything below 40 hertz, really. Simple as that. So let's hear it. Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like, and it kind of just gives a little space for the kick drum. But as you can tell, we're not compressing much, like a couple dB at most. And then we have a post EQ. Filtering out these like super lows, like below 30 hertz. Again, sometimes you don't need that. Most humans can barely hear it. So it's just going to shake a speaker and it's going to mean you're not going to get as much volume out of the track. And then we're increasing about, 120 hertz, 117. Just get a little more punchiness out of the kick. We're pulling some of this, the boxy, 500 out. And there's just a really slight like wide band EQ at, it's only a half dB at 10K. Just boosting some of the higher frequencies, just giving it a little shine. So after those two, then I do my limiting with Pro L. I have Pro L and Pro L2. Usually I'll use Pro L2. For some reason, I use Pro L on this one. It's just quick to get to. And we're just doing 6 dB using this synth pop extra impact. Don't let the name fool you, synth pop. It doesn't matter. Basically, I just like the way that this handles transients of kicks. So that's the reason I like to jump to that setting. So let's hear what all of the whole mastering job is doing. So So this is no mastering at all. So baby, what you trying to do? Now we're going to add it. You know two. I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like any meeny money mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Yeah, any meeny money mo. Which one of you little niggas trying to be my hoe? Which one? So that's kind of the mastering job. And one other thing to note, I'm also using Heat, which is a, sorry, let's show it off here. Heat is sort of a built-in saturation built into Pro Tools. And I'm not messing with the tone. I'm pushing the drive a little bit. Let's listen to the mix with and without Heat, just so you can hear what it does. Oh yeah, just broke up with my dude. Had one nigga, now I need two. So baby, what you trying to do? You know I'm picky, so I'm trying to choose. Like any. So it just kind of tightens everything a little bit. I like to use it. Sometimes I'll play only with one click on it. Sometimes two. Sometimes I'll mess with the tone. But in this case, just two clicks, good to go. So that's the mix, really. Again, not too complicated, real simple stuff. But you want to make sure those kicks are really cutting through. Those 808s are, providing all the low end. Those have to work well together. In this case, they work really well together. And other than that, just like simple trap drums and one loop. I mean, a lot of these, if you're a producer out there, it doesn't take much to make a great hip hop record. You just got to have a feel for rhythm and, drum sounds. And if you have a really good loop that you're playing with, or you can play a really cool melody and repeat it, I mean, that's kind of what most hip hop records are nowadays. So, simple production, but really effective. Sounds like a hit to me. I guess we'll see when it's released. So thank you to Young Baby Tate for letting me do this and letting me mix your record. As soon as the record is available, I will put a link in the description box below so you can go stream it on Spotify or Apple Music, whatever you're using. And yeah, that was the mix. Till next time, I'm DJ Swivel. Make sure you like, subscribe. Peace.